A couple from the upstate will be among the dozens of former contestants from NBC's hit show The Biggest Loser to be featured on a reunion special that airs tonight. New at 6, News 4's Gabrielle Komorowski tells us how the show has changed the couple's lives and how Biggest Losers do Thanksgiving.
And then we'll try to eat sweet potatoes because they're really, really good for you, sweet potatoes without the butter and...
Like many of us, Amy and Phil Parham have Thanksgiving dinner on their minds. But they will be spending the beginning of the holiday doing something they never could have done just a few years ago.
We're actually going to get out and run a 5K race in the morning, and then we're going to eat some turkey and dressing.
The couple from Simpsonville were double the size they are now when they appeared on The Biggest Loser in 2008.
I lost 105 pounds. My husband lost 151, so 256 together.
In the years since the show, they have kept that weight off and kept each other motivated.
Because she'll kick my butt. She's like, you look like you're getting a little weight on you. You need to get back in the gym or something. But
that can-do attitude turned the Parhams into successful authors. Their book, The 90-Day Fitness Challenge, helps readers achieve their goals. They will also be holding a local fitness challenge in Malden next month.
We can empathize with people because we've been in that situation.
It's because of their commitment to fitness that the Parhams were selected to be featured on The Biggest Loser reunion show airing Wednesday night.
And so to be validated in that way and to recognize that we are really trying to use this experience to help other people was, you know, it was a nice pat on the back.
As they continue to help people gain from their tremendous weight loss.
Before, all I could ever think about was getting up and walking to the refrigerator.
Get your attention.
So just have a whole life change, whole mental change. And I want other people to see that it's possible.
Gabrielle Komorowski, WYFF News 4.